Hey, roll a patrol!
How do you people out here know that song?
They're everywhere.
You won't get in trouble.
Okay.
I'm not worried about this one. It's the last one. Like I said, we got scolded pretty bad. Or I got scolded pretty bad. About the break of day, a couple emerged from a dim cafe. A great big car was waiting there to escort them far away. And I was very much astonished when I heard the young man say,
"What did he say?
Oh, won't you roll the patrol? My grandmother can't stand that high. My grandmother, usually so quiet. I'm so sorry she started that riot. Can't understand. All she had was 16 shots of rye.
We can do that one too.
I'll even get off my chair.
Oh my God. Sneezing.
You don't have to get on your knees, sir. We'll do it. Oh, go ahead. This is W.C. Henry's Yellow Dog Blues.
Thank you. are here, right here in this room, and we're going to close off and feature Mr. Joe Lukasik over there in a traditional jazz tune called the Clarinet Marmalade.
That's you.
Oh.
Here's
oh,
okay.
Your Joe.
Which Joe?
There you go, Joe.
All right. Oh, the other Joe.
Four beats. One, two, three.
sponsors, Howard Ruth Brerin, the Riverboat. Welcome to the Clarion Hotel. Don't forget we've got our other room over there, you know, you got to kind of walk around and enjoy the air conditioning. And let's put our hands together, ladies and gentlemen, for the Andy Shum and his gang. Huh?
We're going to move right on to some more music. This is a slow tune that Bix recorded with Paul Whiteman, 1928, titled Love Nest.
Thank you.
John Otto on sax. Dave Bach on trombone. David Boring on some piano. Via Beeson on banjo. Mr. Giordano on telephone. And Josh Duffy on drums. Well, we're going to give Vince a vocal after that last tune. This is one of my favorite tunes, recorded by the Whiteman Orchestra. Vince has a great arrangement of this with a full band. So are we going to hear that later?
Yes,
we're going to hear that later.
If you request it, I'll play it.
You'll get the Reader's Digest version right now. So here we go with Because My Baby Don't Mean Maybe Now.
Thank you.
Mr. Dono on vocals.
Keep drinking.
We're going to go back to the days of the Wolverines back in Chicago and Indiana. The tune entitled Lazy Daddy. It's kind of an interesting tune. There's two takes of it, and George Brunis plays trombone on it, and I think he plays a comb or a kazoo solo on there. But the interesting thing behind the solo, I think Bix is playing piano. Would you agree with that?
I would.
Okay. Yes. The band agrees with me. That's because I'm a leader, right?
You're going to give us checks at the end, right?
I don't think I'm brave enough to play a piano solo at Dave Boardinghouse here on piano, like Bix did, but we'll give it a shot anyway. Sans kazoo solo, because we don't have one. Does anybody have one?
Hey!
It's
an
Avenger
case.
Really?
Uh-oh.
Let's have a vote. Should we do a kazoo solo or not?
Yes!
Can you get it?
Yeah, for somebody in the band who's gonna pull it up. No, who should do it?
Let's make sure it works now. Test it.
Yeah. Let's
see if it works.
Sounds good.
I could try to play the thing. Should we try to switch? No. Like Lazy Daddy.
I don't care.
We should try it.
You wanna?
All right, we're gonna be adventurous. We're gonna try like the record. I don't know if it's gonna work. Let me see where where it goes. Where is the solo? It's just
here. Look at this.
It's like the record. And then I play from here.
Okay. Good.
We're gonna go out.
All right, here we go.
Featured Bing Crosby on it. Quite a nice vocal. We're gonna do it without the vocal, but it's a nice tune anyway. Lovable. we're going to go move on with a tune that Bix didn't record, but I wish he did. It's a really nice, pretty melody. A little reminiscent of Singing the Blues, I think. It's titled At Sundown.
Do a full one by yourself with the cocktail?
No?
Okay.
Well, I mean, I'd rather.
Okay, all right, okay. Let's go right on.
Thank you.
We're going to move away from the Bix repertoire, but stay in the same vein. Name of this tune is You Can't Cheat a Cheater. That's great. David Bolling has arranged this for us. This is our first time. I shouldn't admit to you that we're doing that, but it's our first.
Yes,
we should. Okay, then you give us a pass. If it's bad, you'll maybe hear it again. Maybe you won't.
You know what? I didn't get right all the phrasing in one place, something different that was written, especially John.
Okay. Okay. Something special about working with this group, we get to do a lot of neat material that most of us don't get to do in everyday life. This is one of those tunes that is loved by record collectors and people of the like. I'm sorry, I've got no control of the
sound, right?
Back here, they can't. And something special about this record is that Tommy Dorsey played trumpet on it. Most of us, we know him as a trombone player, but he was a great hot trumpet player, so we'll see if I can emulate that a little bit. But he sounds a lot like...
The Philippolians.
Oh.
This is the Philippolians.
Oops. Uh-oh.
That's all right. It's okay.
You
can play like Tommy Dorsey anyway.
Okay, I'll be playing like Tommy Dorsey, I guess. That's a fantasy record. You can't cheat a cheater. I'm buying beer tonight, I guess.
Okay, ready?
Okay, yep.
Thank you.
for Leah Bees. I never heard her play a single string solo. That's a rarity. If that was a record, all the collectors would be trying to get that one. Ooh, it's rare, Leah Bees and single string solo.
Ah, shit.
That was great. And with that, we're gonna never sit down for a number. Sit down for a number.
Yeah, some of my nerves.
Bring up our kazoo player. This is Jason Schreiber. Everybody say hello to Jason. Hi. Jason was Dave Bach and I go ways back, listening to records and playing tunes and playing really bad gigs and the like. But Jason was involved with us for a while too, until he moved away to Arizona. But now he's back, so we're welcoming him back with a Gold Cat tune, and he plays this beautiful. What kind of banjo is this?
This is a
Epiphone Recording A. Oh, I like that 20s stuff.
Yeah.
Josh has more information about this tune than I have, so he's a Gold Cat expert. So. See, if you had a megaphone, this wouldn't be a problem.
This one is one the Gold Cat band did not record, but the list of composers and everybody is off to the right-hand side here. I'm going to run down for you. Music by Gene Goldkett, Ray Ludwig, Don Murray, and Charles Horvath, with lyrics by Howdy Quicksell. So it was a collaboration of all these great Goldkett men in 1925. They wrote the songs entitled You Are Just a Vision.
And the sheet music has a guy smoking a cigarette, and the smoke is billowing up, and there's his dame in the smoke.
Dame. How dare you call a tomato that?
Chorus to a verse.
His lady in the chorus.
Chorus and then his record. How dare
you refer to a baby that way?
Thank you.
Pop tune. Actually, I heard it's from the 20s. It's from a movie. It's the movie.
Good News.
Yes.
It's called Just Imagine. I also have a Benny Carter record of it, which is very good.
Well,
they
cut
thank you.
203. There's nothing in there. It's the molars one, but it's just played to us. F, F, chorus, C, verse. It's just a blank sheet. F, and then go to the chorus. I mean the verse and C.
Like verse and C.
We're going to go out of the Bix repertoire again, and the next tune is going to be Alexander's Ragtime Band, and that's a pretty common tune, but one of the records I really enjoy is Myth Mullen with Little Molars, and it's Myth Mullen, Red Nichols, and they do a very interesting version of the melody, just them two with the rhythm section, so we'll try that out for you here today. Alexander's Ragtime Band. Yeah, chorus, and then you come in on the chorus.
Thank you.
We got Dave Bach on trombone. John Otto on reed. David Bonus on piano. Rhea Beaton on banjo and guitar. Jim Cardano on bass. Scott Tuffy on drums. I'm Andy Schein. And we have Tracy join us for this last tune, recorded by Frank Trumbauer, Love Affairs. And back in the 20s, sometimes you'd have both a guitar and a banjo in the band. I've never done that before, so we're going to give it a shot. Experimental. This is experimental avant-garde music, folks. So here we go with Love Affairs.
There's a big sax solo.
Yeah, something is working, I believe. So.